Good Takers. I'm Eddie Reese. This is the first take. Today we're going to check out the Poltergeist trailer 2. I wasn't going to bother with this one. It came out a couple of days ago, but you know what I mean? I'm starting to warm up to it a bit. You know, I wasn't that interested in seeing a sequel. No, it's not even a sequel, I'm not saying. It's the reboot of the classic Poltergeist films, which I saw when I was a kid. But, you know, the first trailer wasn't so bad. So let's just jump into this. You know, Sam Rockwell's in it, and I've always got time for Sam Rockwell. Let's see what they got.
I came with Maddie! Maddie? We have to call somebody.
You can't call the cops. What are you gonna tell them? First things first. Your daughter is here and she's alive. This development was built on a cemetery. But this isn't just a few pissed off spirits. It's a poltergeist. They are trapped and desperate. And Maddie is their ticket out.
We just want our daughter back.
The door to their world can close at any moment. If that happens,
then it looks like a girl.
Help me.
I want your
rag doings.
They already know what scares you.
Dude, it looks alright. A lot of people complaining. And that fucking clown, I'll stick it up here. That clown looks freaky as fuck. I've never been a person who's been scared of clowns, but look at it, it's freaky. A lot of people complaining about the PG-13 rating, but Poltergeist was never that sort of horror film that relied on gore and blood and brutality in order to get the scares across. It was always more of a psychological thing. It was always more about the tone, the sense of trepidation with the family being in danger and the kids being missing and all of that shit. So I think you can get around it. And that trailer looks like they're getting around it pretty damn well. I can see... Need to eat. That looks right to me. A lot of people complaining and bitching, but I think I'm going to give that a go. So what do you think of the whole PG-13 rating? Do you prefer all horror films to be 18 or R-rated as it is in the States? Does it really make a difference? If the director is good at what they do and the writer is good at what they do, do you think that they need it to be R-rated or 18? Or do you need to have that brutality there? You need the blood in order to get the scares across. Let me know right down below. If you like the video, please subscribe, give me a thumbs up. I'm Eddie Reese. This will be my first take.